Medical Watch is sponsored by UChicago Medicine, bringing expert primary and urgent care close to home with locations throughout Chicagoland. Schedule online at uchicagomedicine.org.
On the Medical Watch, doctors told her her brain was one in a million. And while the finding was anything but welcome, she knows the experts who identified her colloid cyst likely saved her life.
This is looking at your brain here, and we're separating the two folds in the surface of your brain right there.
Watching her own brain surgery.
Dr. McGill saw me at 4:45, admitted me to the hospital, and operated the next afternoon.
Captivated Leslie Fenton Para.
One of the first things you have to do is drain the cyst. So I think right here, this is a knife that I slid all the way down in your brain a couple millimeters, and we puncture that cyst.
That cyst isn't something doctors see very often.
The incidence is about one in a million for this cyst, so it's pretty rare. I trained at one of the busiest neurosurgery programs in the country, and I think in training and then in practice, you see them about once a year.
As soon as you see it, you immediately identify what it is.
Called a colloid cyst, the distinctive anomaly likely formed at birth.
This is basically a fluid-filled structure like a balloon that's effectively obstructing the outflow of your spinal fluid from your brain.
As it grew, pressure built up in the 68-year-old's brain.
There were significant motor and cognitive deficits.
Leslie's husband, Mark, was the first to spot the symptoms, similar to a stroke.
She wasn't keeping up. She wasn't slurring her speech, but it was clearly slower than what, you know, I was accustomed to hearing from her. So there was clearly something wrong going on. I wasn't quite sure what.
When you came in, I don't know if you remember, you were walking very wide like this, and you were holding on to him for a couple weeks even before that. Trouble walking, headaches, blurry vision. Sometimes people have drop attacks where their legs give out from underneath them, confusion, sometimes memory problems.
For Leslie, there was another strange sign of trouble.
I did notice several days before that my handwriting had just become completely illegible, and my signature, which is pretty specific, did not look like me anymore.
Northwestern Medicine neurosurgeon Dr. Stephen McGill acted fast.
If it gets to the point where it's totally closed off, then there are reports of sudden death from this.
Working through a 1-inch incision in the skull, Dr. McGill first placed a plastic tube to separate the folds of Leslie's brain and place his instruments.
All the work that I'm doing is through that.
The approach helps protect the delicate area that controls memory formation.
And then we can take the cyst out. Now it's wide open all the way across. You can even see the fluid pulsating in and out. If I remove all of the membrane, all of the cyst wall, it should not come back.
3 months after her surgery, the fluid in Leslie's brain has returned to normal.
So your CT scan today looked terrific.
Oh, good.
The ventricles are down. There's no pressure on the brain around it.
No signs of the rare cyst.
It's really hard for me to say. Very grateful.
Doctors say the majority of patients with colloid cysts may never require surgery. In Leslie's case, since fluid buildup was so great, surgeons had to intervene. Back to you.